This game is tea and is not suitable for kids.
We are still not on the Kotomi route, apparently. Wow. I open my eyes and I see that I'm in my room. I feel like I was having a bad dream. I'm drenched in sweat. Haven't we seen this dialogue before? My head on still on my pillow, I look around. The light only faintly illuminates the room, making it hard to tell if it's sunrise or sunset. I lean over and look at the clock to see what time it is. May 8th, Thursday morning. I feel tired. I vaguely remember brooding and worrying until late into the night. Suddenly, it all comes back to me. It's only been one day since the incident. I can't believe it. Kotomi just crumpled to the ground and started sobbing. Then she went home on her own without saying anything to me. I flop back onto the bed again. Feelings of confusion keep washing over me. It's like back when I couldn't help but run away despite having nowhere to go. I knew that there wasn't a solution, but I thought something would change if I only kept worrying about it. I was the only one who thought that that was acceptable. If I fall back to sleep now, I won't feel like going to school when I wake up. That's how I lie to myself and take my mind off my problems. I get out of bed. I sluggishly put on my uniform. Get on you, man! Don't run away. I don't want to escape into that fog of uncertainty anymore. Tomoya has books in his room because he used to be big into reading. And he, like, when he was younger, he bought a ton of books and now he doesn't like it anymore. Or maybe that's his way of falling asleep, I don't know. The school is the same as always this morning. Nothing seems different from yesterday. By the time I reach the campus, homeroom is about to start. I hurry to Class A instead of my own classroom. No, this is our class. I look for the open door, but I don't see Kotomi anywhere. I walk up to a group of three girls standing at the back of the classroom. I want to talk to Ichinose. A girl with glasses, who looks like the leader of this group, peers at me suspiciously. She looks around the classroom and says,
でも、あの人って確か今まで
I don't think it was a seizure, I think it was like a panic attack.
なに?発作って。私もわかんないけど、なんかすごかったみたいよ。みんなが見てる前で泣き叫んじゃって。うわぁ、それってなんかありそう。頭良すぎるもんね、あの人。
I turn around to leave.
Oh,
he's got a lot of problems. I hear dissatisfied grumblings from behind. I don't say a word as I head back into my own classroom. I can't stand hearing them call Kotomi that girl anymore. I'm lost in thought for most of the morning. I'm still thinking about yesterday. I go over my memories delicately as if touching bird scars. In between her sobs, Kotomi was repeating something. She was trying really hard to move as if running away from something only she could see. She looked like a little girl to me. Kotomi was subconsciously remembering something. What could it have been? I just don't know. There's no way I could know anyway. I shake my head. The bell rings to mark the end of the morning classes. Thinking about this won't change anything. So, there's only one thing left to do. I've written games? I mean, I have a GitHub, yeah. I think the only things there, though, are like my Zumbini's algorithms for when I Let's Played it. If there's anything else up there, I forgot about it. The teachers are just starting their lunch break in the office. I bow before entering and see the guidance counselor glaring at me. However, I have business with the Class A teacher at the moment. I wait at her desk for her to return from class. Excuse me.
あら、何かしら、 岡崎君。
Is Ichinose absent today?
ええ、しばらく休ませてほしいって連絡受けてるわ。
How long is some time?
ちょっとわからないわね。ほら、昨日が昨日だったから。
The word yesterday rings strangely in my ears. She means that it's not something strangers should stick their nose into. But I don't want to consider myself a stranger to Kotomi anymore. Please tell me Ichinose's address.
Ichinose-san の家?
I stare straight back at the teacher, who is bewilderedly looking at me. I know that no explanation would be good enough for her. After this short staring contest, she gives a resigned laugh. She puts the textbook and attendance sheet she's carrying on the desk.
ちょっと待ってね。
I know who you are. You're Mr. Absent. She sits down and takes out a different register of names.
住所が分かればいいのよね。
Yes. She tears off a piece of paper and copies the address onto it.
お見舞いに行くの?
Yes.
でも、今はそっとしてあげた方がいいかもしれないわね。それにほら、一ノ瀬さんのお宅って…
She starts to say something, but quickly stops herself.
一ノ瀬さんから何か聞いてる?
No.
そう。なら、私から言うべきではないわね。
Good on you, teacher. Please don't give out students' addresses to random people asking for them.
お見舞いに行くのはいいけど、あまり一ノ瀬さんに負担をかけないこと。
Oh, no, no, never mind. She's still giving us the address. Okay. Yes.
ならよろしい。
I slide the piece of paper into my pocket.
最近、一ノ瀬さん明るくなってきたから、私としても喜んでたんだけどね。
I make a quick bow and move to leave. But in the next moment…
岡崎くん、一つ質問…
I thought the guidance counselor's gonna be like, You're not going anywhere. Yes?
あなた今、一ノ瀬さんと付き合ってる?
Well, yes, but actually no. It's the same type of question the gentleman from the other day asked. What a tough question to answer. You've gone on a date with her, you're holding hands, you both clearly like each other, and you just haven't asked each other out yet. What? Okay, so I'm looking at the spoiler-free walkthrough, and apparently it does not matter which one we pick. Bye, Kyoroot. Bye. if I were in this situation, I would say, why ask something like that? Why do you ask? I answer a question with a question, avoiding the issue.
一ノ瀬さんが一種の特別扱いを受けてることはあなたも知ってるわよね。
Yes. As long as her test scores are good, she doesn't need to attend her classes. In the beginning, I envied this freedom that was given to Kotomi. But I think it's strange. She must have wanted to be with the other students.
そうね。
She nods deeply and then waves for me to come closer. What she's about to say must be a secret. Why? To this teacher, random dude shows up like, Hey, I want to know where this girl lives. She's like, okay, are you dating her? Why are you asking that? Well, let me let you in on all her dirty secrets. It's like, what? This teacher doesn't seem very responsible.
私から言える範囲で説明するとね。
Maybe she's seen us in the class before?
ずっと昔に一ノ瀬さんのご家族のことが。新聞やテレビで盛んに取り上げられた時期があるの。一ノ瀬さんは注目されたし、そのせいでいじめられもした。
Oh no! I figured she was bullied in the past, and she kept asking, like, is she a bully?
だから、一ノ瀬さんのことを知っている大人はね、みんなこう思ってきたの。
Kids are jerks sometimes.
できるだけ、そっとしておいてあげたいって。
Oh.
でもそのせいで一ノ瀬さんは、一人でいることに慣れてしまった。
This is so sad.
それは私たちが間違っていたせいでもある。
Yeah, you don't just leave her alone if she's being bullied. You gotta stop the bullying. Easier said than done, though.
だから誰かが一ノ瀬さんを変えてあげなければいけないの。
She looks at me straight in the eye as she says these words.
納得したならもう一度聞くわ。あなたは今。
Because of what she said, it's even harder to answer her.
答えにくいなら、質問を変えるわね。今、あなたの存在は、一ノ瀬さんに影響を与えていると思う?
That is a definite yes. In some ways, that's even harder to answer.
イエスかノーで簡潔に。
I answer her, yes.
そう。なら、聞いてちょうだい。本当はこれも私から言うべきことではないけれど。
She prefaces her statement and then lowers her voice.
一ノ瀬さんに 海外留学の話があるのは知ってる?
What? This is the first I've heard of it. I didn't know.
特別科学奨学生という制度ができてね。今年からテスト運用されるの。
You wonder if she was going to the library to make friends? Like, she could go to any library in town. Oh, that would be sad.I think she basically got to the point where she accepted she was never going to have friends, and then she basically was like, books are the only company I will have.
国が全額費用を負担して、アメリカの大学を1年間特別受講できるって。
Oh, well, American University, heck yeah.
一ノ瀬さんも候補に入っているの。事前の評価からすると、もう内定に近いんだけど。
I wonder if that's gonna be like the good ending or the bad ending where she goes abroad.There are only 5 openings for honor students in science courses. Because it's such a big honor, the school wants her to be in the program. She explains that to me too.
でも、一ノ瀬さん、火曜日に一度断ったのよ。みんなと一緒に勉強したいって。
She probably would have accepted if she didn't make friends with us.
私もそれがいいって賛成したんだけど。今朝ね。留学の話を進めてくださいって言ってきたの。
It's like someone doused me with a bucket of cold water. What would happen if she goes abroad? This is the best I can muster.
休学して1年間アメリカで暮らすことになるわね。
What would happen after that?
本人次第ね。日本に戻ってきてもいいし、向こうの大学に進むこともできるから。ただ、本気で学問を志すなら、日本に帰ってくるメリットは少ない。と言わなければならないわね。
I can't do anything but stay quiet. I really don't understand why Kotomi would make this decision now. But there's one thing I'm certain of. If I let her go overseas, I'll never see Kotomi again.
留学のことはとりあえず、私のところで止めてあるわ。ただね、来週ぐらいには結論を出さないといけないことは覚えておいてちょうだい。
All right.
それから、分かってると思うけど、今の話は内密に頼むわね。
Yes.
頑張りなさい。いろいろな意味でね。
Thank you, teacher without a face.Not sure why you don't have a face, but random one-off teacher from Misai's past had a face. But oh well, I didn't make the game. I bow once more before leaving the teacher's office.
Tomoya-kun, konnichiwa.
The usual greeting. I spin around.
Hi, genki.
Oh, it's you.
こんなに露骨に落胆されると、ちょっと焼けちゃうわね。
I purposefully sounded disappointed. Her usual joking attitude lightens the mood a bit.
Kotomi, 休みみたいね。
Yeah. I'm short of my answer.
職員室で何してたの?
Getting lectured as usual.
Hmm.
She looks at me with a grin. Just go in. You want something from them too, right? She places her thumb on the handle of the sliding door to the teacher's office and says,
はいはい。
As she's about to open up the door, she turns to me.
そうだ、今日の放課後だけど、演劇部室は多分誰もいないからね。
Random construction worker did have a sprite. Yeah, that's true. Is something going on?
秘密。
She says that suggestively. Whatever. I have something to do today, so I can't go anyway.
じゃあちょうどいいわね。出てきたらまたビシビシ鍛えてあげるからね。それと、亮と部長がまた一緒にお昼食べましょうだって。
She seems to know exactly what's going on. Tell her yourself. I'm not your messenger.
バカね。王子様が一人で助けに行かないと意味ないでしょ。
Oh, please.
失礼します。
She enters the teacher's office before I can respond.When the last class of the afternoon ends, I dash out of the classroom. I run down the slope in front of the school and hurry on my way. I stop at the intersection where I normally part ways with Kotomi. Trying to catch my breath, I take a piece of paper out of my pocket. The note indicates a place I'm not familiar with. I spent all of the afternoon classes looking at this piece of paper instead of listening to the teachers. Great use of your time! I doubt that Kotomi has to walk too far from where we part ways. I'm confident we can find it. Or I can find it. No, I have to find it. I continue on with the paper clutched in my hand. Guided by the signs affixed to the utility poles, I wander down several streets. Okay, he clearly doesn't have a phone. I would have to have a GPS. Oh, welcome back, Chris! Yeah, Kotomi had her breakdown after the, not actually bus incident, but kind of bus incident. And now we're trying to find her house. This area seems like a high-class neighborhood with mansions built on huge plots of land. I look at the nameplates for each household. However, I still can't find the address I'm looking for. Maybe it's not around here. Each time I turn a corner, I'm disappointed anew. Before I realize it, the sun is setting. My shadow has grown long and darkens the street before me. The wind has also gotten much colder. The smells of dinner are emanating from the houses around me. I experience a feeling of warmth and nostalgia. There's also an irritating feeling of something strangely familiar that I can't quite put my finger on. It should be around here. Noticing how I'm desperately trying to remember something, I laugh wryly at myself. There's no way I'd be familiar with this area. No point in trying to find it in my memories. Maybe this was a reckless attempt to begin with. I could have just looked up the address on a map and found it right away. Maybe I should try again tomorrow. On the verge of giving up, I round one more corner. The house before me looks familiar. Oh! New background. It's a large two-story house surrounded by a metal fence painted white. I cautiously look at the nameplate. Ichinose. Yeah, this game was released in 2004-2005, I think. So, this was before phones had GPSs. Without thinking, I run forward. There's a doorbell to the side of the wooden door. I go to press it, but hesitate for some reason. This doesn't feel right. I never went in through the front door. I look around. There's a narrow path running between the perimeter of the house and a hedge. In the shadow of a storage shed is a bucket, a shovel, and a rusted lawnmower. The path must lead to a garden. I walk along that path. Twilight is setting in. I smell the scent of grass. The feeling of asphalt under my feet gives way to that of soft soil. This is a new background too, wow! Now we're getting the new backgrounds! The garden is in disarray. The grass has been left uncut and weeds of all kinds have grown tall. A couple of garden chairs sit next to a tilting table. The paint is crusted off, showing dark red rust. The wind, brought by the dusk, blows through the forgotten ruins of this place. I can't do anything but stand here. This isn't how it's supposed to be. The grass was always cleanly cut. Yeah, we've been here before. The chairs and the table were painted bright white. A brick wall was surrounding a flower bed full of blooming flowers. A dreamland had always awaited me. There's an opening at the corner of the hedge that I used to use as my way in. Huh? What is this? This feeling. I think they call it deja vu. I know this place. But I don't know how I know it. I push through the weeds and silently take one step at a time. The overgrown grass tangles my feet, trying to block my path. I need to go to the living room facing the garden. A tall glass door with a wooden frame separates the inside from the outside world. The curtain is closed, blocking me from seeing what's inside. As if it's some sort of signal, I notice that the far edge of the glass door is open just a crack. That's probably the same as it was in the past. I pull at the sliding door with all of my strength and it creaks loudly. It moves to the side, little by little. I take off my shoes and enter the living room. It's dark inside. The wooden flooring is engulfed by the stale, dusty air. It has the mysterious smell of faded western sun rays. I focus my eyes and look around. There's a table in the middle of the room surrounded by a sofa, and a side table rests against the wall. Their textures are completely gone, as if they've carved from stone. I'm sure that they haven't been touched in years. I cautiously press on deeper past the living room. In the middle of the hallway is a set of stairs. Each step takes me slowly upward. Key certainly didn't save money on their backgrounds, they're amazing. Yeah. Oh, Higurashi literally uses photos of a filter on them. Yeah. I still have this bizarre feeling of being drawn forward by some memories that don't belong to me. I tiptoe toward a door at the far end of the second floor. I still don't understand how I know this place. And I stand in front of the farthest door. I fumble at the doorknob and turn it. It isn't locked. This is also the same as it's always been. I slowly open the door. As long as you don't gently open it. The aroma of old paper wafts through the orange light, with orange light. I open the door and look inside. It seems to be a study. Books line all four walls. Deeper in the room is a grand wooden desk. And... oh no! And we get the sad music! Everyone get ready to cry. Oh wow. I freaking love this outfit, but... and this is where all the her cut pages are going. She looks so sad, though. Kotomi is sitting on the floor. Scattered beside her are cutouts of bits and pieces of old newspapers, magazines, and books. The spread of a faded newspaper catches my eye. A fishing boat witnesses the crash in Alaskan waters. All 266 crew members and passengers are feared dead. Among the passenger list are the Ichinoses, sending shockwaves through the world of physics. The unannounced super unification theory fades into illusion. I have not played Katawa Shoujo, but I have seen people play Katawa Shoujo, and it is definitely good. Although, I could do without the sex scenes. Slivers of pages from books are scattered all around, like soldiers who died protecting Kotomi. I pick one up. Horizontal text is printed across the pages. Regarding the Kalabi Yao manifold of the ADE type isolated singularity, the recently reorganized posthumous manuscripts of the late Ichinoses. The fragment slips from my fingers. The late Ichinoses. Memories intersect. A snow-white apron, the smell of a classy tobacco pipe. A beautiful grassy yard that looks as if it came right out of a dream. That's right. Kotomi is the little girl from back then. I knew they had met before! Knew it! All she could do was sit on the floor and cry. Orange flames dance in front of my eyes. Kotomi. My own voice has an empty echo to it. Hazy images are all I can recall. But even with just those, I know. I know this room, this house, and Kotomi. Kotomi and I met when we were kids. And yet, I was the only one who forgot. You knew it was me from the beginning, didn't you? Kotomi doesn't say anything. Why didn't you tell me? Those words aren't directed at Kotomi. I'm disappointed with myself. Kotomi refuses to look at me and I stay silent. Then she slowly opens her mouth.
あの時の男の子が戻ってきてくれたんだって私のこと忘れずにいてくれたんだってでも二人でいるうちに 私のこと忘れてるみたいって気づいて、それなのに私と友達になってくれて、初めて会った女の子として私のこと大切にしてくれて。
Yeah, we became friends with her twice. That probably meant a lot to her. Kotomi then adds,
In other words,
you literally ignore her. Yep. And I've done that in a lot of the roots, and now I'm kind of feeling bad for that. Like, I think it actually would have been nicer to her to just never have met her again.